Sweet. Cool. of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Dear friends, we have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Matthew Tyler Bellassai and Amanda Christie Blanchett, to surround them with our prayers and to share in their joy. The Bible teaches us that the covenant of marriage is a gift from God. It's a holy mystery in which a man and woman are one flesh. Father, what joy we have today, how good to celebrate marriage, to participate in the union of this man and this woman, in the bond of eternal love that you have guided and blessed. And so we pray that today will be a memorable and strong beginning for this marriage, and Matthew be a sterling example of Christ's love for his church, and may Amanda be a worthy pattern of the church's devotion to Christ. May all of us surround them with our support and encouragement so that their union will endure in faithfulness and happiness. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So, Matt and Amanda, I'm going to ask you now before God and this congregation to affirm your willingness to enter into this covenant of marriage and to share all of the joys and sorrows of this new relationship, whatever the future may hold. Matthew, will you today take Amanda to be your wife, to live together according to God's plan for marriage? If so, please answer, I will. And do you promise to love her and remain faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, please answer, I do. And Amanda, will you today take Matthew to be your husband, to live together according to God's plan for marriage? If so, please answer, I will. And do you promise to love him and remain faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, please answer, I do. I'd like to invite now the families of Amanda and Matthew to please stand. If you're, whatever you consider to be family, like you could be third cousin, twice removed, or whatever, if you're part of the family, I'm going to ask you as they pledge their lives to each other, would you offer Matthew and Amanda your prayerful blessing? And will you promise to do all you can to support and encourage them in their journey of marriage? If so, please answer, we promise. Please be seated. The scripture that Matthew and Amanda have chosen is from the Apostle Paul's letter to the Church of Corinth, chapter 13. I'm not reading all of it, but I am reading most of it. Paul writes, "If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I give all I possess to give to the poor, give my body to hardship so that I may boast, but do not have love, I'm nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It doesn't envy. It doesn't boast. It isn't proud. It doesn't dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered and keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. Always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres, for love never fails." When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. So Matthew and Amanda, I sat down this morning to write out some personal thoughts for you after our conversations together. And I first just want to thank you for letting me into your lives. We have established a special bond together in a few sessions where we've met. And it's going to be a challenge for you living about 45 minutes away to keep a strong connection to your church, but I hope you'll work hard at it. That will bless me, and more importantly, it will be important for you and your marriage. We're all hardwired to need community, especially a community of people who love Jesus. I've never met a couple quite like you, never had a wedding quite like this one. So it's not surprising to me that you would have unusual parts of your wedding day because you too are unique. Yours is one of those stories that we might subtitle, "You Can't Make This Stuff Up." So a girl is born in New York and she grows up on Navy bases in Bahrain and Italy, and she learns to speak Arabic and Italian and pioneers college in her family and comes to North Carolina to study psychology. She gets a job at a place called Hickory Tavern and meets a boy there. The boy grows up in Maryland and California, finishes high school in North Carolina while living with his grandparents, and then studies engineering. He's the head server at Hickory Tavern. He meets the girl, but he thinks she's terrible at her job, and he falls in love with her anyway. So among other questions, one would naturally ask, knowing your story, can an engineer and a psychologist have a happy marriage? The engineer is about facts and numbers and systems and order, and the psychologist is about people and connections and that which can't be plotted on a spreadsheet. Engineering is about what can be observed and planned. Psychology is about what's largely invisible and often mysterious. But opposites attract. There's a sense in which that's true of every marriage, though. You're fundamentally different. For one thing, you're boy and girl, and God simply hardwired male and female to be simultaneously incompatible and irresistible. If irreconcilable differences are grounds for divorce, then every marriage has grounds for divorce. And that's why 1 Corinthians 13 is so perfect for your marriage. This passage is often taken in isolation. It's true that it's beautiful even when it stands alone, but it doesn't stand alone. It's part of a letter that Paul wrote to a church that had irreconcilable differences. And one of their conflicts was over their insistence that everyone's uniqueness was better than somebody else's uniqueness, that they had a right to be right and a right to be me. And some of them insisted that the ability to speak other languages, even a heavenly language, was the greatest evidence of spirituality, and others insisted on order and individual and understandability. The Apostle Paul strikes this beautiful balance. And he says these differences are God-given, and nobody can say to somebody else in the church, "I don't need you." And he begins this chapter, "Even if I speak in the tongues of men and of angels," in other words, if I'm a model of spiritual attainment, but I'm love, it doesn't matter. And it doesn't matter what you can do or what you accomplish or even how much you sacrifice or give, if you don't love, it's nothing. And that's so true of marriage. You're created to love. You're created in the image of God, who loves throughout eternity, His Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And the essence of love is mutual submission, just giving up the right to be right, giving up the right to be yourself in order that the marriage itself might be strong. Matthew demanded nothing you've experienced so far in your relationship would be exactly what it's like from the moment I pronounce your husband and wife and join Teddy and Taylor in making it official before the state of North Carolina. Courtship, engagement, and even living in the same house, it's all about love in the present. When you marry, it's about love in the future. It's about saying that no matter what unexpected twists and turns life takes, we will be Matthew and Amanda together. Paul says love keeps waiting, and it keeps forgiving, and it keeps giving the benefit of doubt, and it never stops trusting. Love's not a feeling, it's a commitment to never, ever, 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 ever give up. It's so much easier to love when we have an escape hatch. But Mary says we're not choosing any escape hatch, and that's what makes it so hard, and it's also what makes it so wife and I were standing in a church up in Pennsylvania all those years ago, and life has turned us lots of curves. We never would have thought we'd be here in Hickory, North Carolina. I never thought I'd be standing in front of you, officiating at a wedding. But here we are, and through all those years, love just grows richer and deeper. So Paul even closes the chapter by saying that love is greater than hope or faith. But I thought about that. Why is love greater than hope? It's because there will be times when you can't feel hope or keep the faith. But if you open your eyes, you will see that this person who is closest to you, who's your opposite, is still loving you, still there. And if you keep acting in love, whether or not you feel like it, Without his sacrifice on the cross, your sins could never be forgiven. You couldn't have a relationship with God. But with him, when you trust Christ, you are free from guilt and shame, and that means you're free to love as you have been loved. Even if you're an engineer who keeps our power running, or a psychologist who helps people find and enjoy their forever homes, you can still keep loving and find it richer because you're different. This marriage can last a lifetime, but only by his grace at work in you. Never forget that he's the one who loves you and makes it possible to love each other. The greatest of these is love. Amen. I invite you now to make your promises to one another. If you'll turn and face each other, and then as you do, coming a little bit closer, here we go, getting ready to get married, let's draw in a little bit here. And Matthew, please repeat after me. I, Matthew, take you, Amanda, to be my wedding wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy law, and thereto, I pledge you my faith. Amanda, repeat after me. I, Amanda, take you, Matthew, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy law, and thereto I pledge you my faith. Matthew and Amanda would like to symbolize this commitment before God and before you by exchanging rings. May I have Amanda's ring, please? This wedding ring is a symbol of married love and commitment. It is pure, and under fiery trial, it shines only brighter. Its form is a circle representing a love that never ends. Matthew, place this ring on the fourth finger of Amanda's left hand, and as you hold it there, repeat after me. With this ring, I newlywed, I give you my love, and pledge my faithfulness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May I have that in your place? This ring also is a symbol of married love and commitment to his pure, and under fiery trial shines only brighter. Its form is a circle, representing the love that never ends. Amanda, place this ring in the fourth finger of Matthew's left hand, and as you hold it there, repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed, I give you my love, and pledge you my faithfulness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Matthew and Amanda, you have committed yourselves to each other in the presence of God and of these witnesses. Therefore, as the minister of the gospel and with the authority conferred on me by the state of North Carolina, I love doing this. It sends chills up and down my spine. I pronounce that you are husband and wife. What God has joined together, let no one separate. Matthew, you may kiss your wife. Call them home to yourself. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. grace of Christ attend you. May the love of God surround you. And may the Holy Spirit keep you so that you will grow in holy love, find delight in each other always, and remain faithful until your life's end. So I'm going to invite Megan now to come forward. She's going to sing a solo as they recess. And after I make the presentation, you may applaud again if you so desire. And then keep your places while Megan sings this special song for Matthew and Amanda. Dear friends, it is my privilege now to present to you for the first time as a married couple, Matthew and Amanda Bellassai.
Well, Thank you. Except for the weight of